Hey everyone, and welcome back. Today, we're simulating some of the most spectacular events in the cosmos, galaxy collisions. First up, a clash of titans, our own Milky Way versus its nearest large neighbor, Andromeda. Let's bring them into the simulation. Here's Andromeda, and here's the Milky Way. They are on a collision course that will happen in about 4.5 billion years, but we're gonna speed things up a lot. As they approach, their immense gravitational forces begin to pull on each other. You can see the spiral arms starting to stretch and warp. This is called tidal disruption. The galaxies pass through each other for the first time. It's important to remember that galaxies are mostly empty space, so individual stars rarely ever collide. It's the gas, dust, and gravity that truly interact. Look at these incredible tidal tails being flung out into space. These are long, thin streams of stars and gas drawn out by the gravitational dance. Now for the second pass. The cores are getting closer and the structures are becoming a chaotic, beautiful mess. This is where the real merger begins, triggering a massive wave of star formation, a phenomenon known as a starburst. The two galaxies are now completely intertwined. The spiral structures are almost gone, replaced by a single, larger, and more chaotic blob. Over billions of years, this will settle into a new, giant elliptical galaxy, which astronomers have nicknamed Milkomeda. What an incredible sight. Now let's reset and try something a little different.
All right, for our next experiment here in Universe Sandbox, let's clear the field and start a new simulation from scratch. We'll place one random spiral galaxy here and a second one right beside it. Now let's make this more visually distinct. I'm going into the appearance settings for the first galaxy, which the sim has named Messier 085. I'm thinking, let's cycle through a few options and settle on a nice rich orange. And now for the second one, Pinwheel. To get a good contrast, let's change its color to a vibrant lime green. There, an orange galaxy versus a green one. Perfect. Now, while galaxies aren't actually lime green, their real colors do tell us a lot. Bluish galaxies are typically full of hot, young, newly forming stars, while redder and more orange-colored galaxies are often older, filled with cooler, longer-lived stars. Okay, collision course is set. Let's crank up time and watch the fireworks. I'm also going to turn on the orbits, which are these blue lines, so we can track the paths of the stars. And here they come. Right away, their mutual gravity starts to rip them apart. You can see these incredible tidal tails, long streams of orange and green stars being flung out into space. The blue trails show just how chaotic their new orbits are becoming. They make their first pass, interpenetrating each other. The structures are getting completely mangled, but gravity is relentless. It's pulling them back together for a second, even more intense merger. Look at how the cores are now mixing together. This is where the magic happens. All the gas and dust from both galaxies gets compressed, triggering a massive burst of star formation. The once separate orange and green entities are now becoming a single, turbulent, and beautifully chaotic new galaxy. Let's turn the trails off to get a clearer view. You can see it's no longer two galaxies, but one massive, disorganized cluster of stars glowing from the energy of the collision. That was incredible. Now, let's clear the simulation and set up a true battle of sizes. A massive, giant galaxy against a tiny dwarf galaxy.
All right, we've cleared the simulation. For this next scenario, let's create a true cosmic mismatch. Let's pick a random, small, irregular galaxy. I'll place it right in front of the giant one. Look at that size difference. This is a true David and Goliath scenario. This type of interaction, called galactic cannibalism, is actually incredibly common in the universe. It's one of the main ways that massive galaxies, like our own Milky Way, grow over billions of years by swallowing up their smaller neighbors. Okay, let's press play and speed up time. Immediately, the dwarf galaxy is helplessly caught in the larger one's gravitational well. It doesn't stand a chance. Its structure is already starting to stretch and deform under the immense tidal forces. And there it goes. The giant galaxy is tearing it apart. This process is called tidal stripping. The dwarf galaxy's stars are being pulled away, forming a long, faint stellar stream that's now being siphoned into the larger galaxy. The main body of the dwarf is now being fully absorbed, its stars mixing in with the billions of stars in the spiral arms. Over time, that stream of stolen stars will completely wrap around the giant, becoming part of its vast spherical halo. But the most dramatic part is happening at the core. The two supermassive black holes from the centers of both galaxies are now orbiting each other, locked in a gravitational dance, spiraling closer and closer until they merge into one even larger black hole. Look at it now. A single massive black hole swirling through the beautiful chaos of gas and dust left behind by the collision. Absolutely incredible.
In most extreme scenario, we're taking two large spiral galaxies, just like the ones we've been using, but we're going to break the laws of physics. Let's go into the motion tools, select speed, and set it to 1C, the speed of light. I'll place them on a direct collision course. Now, as soon as I hit play, even with the simulation time slowed to a crawl, they're moving at an insane velocity. We have to slow time down to just a few years per second to even see this happen. Notice something weird. The spiral arms aren't rotating. The galaxies look frozen. That's because their forward velocity is so immense, literally the fastest possible speed in the universe, that their own internal rotation is completely insignificant in comparison. Here comes the impact, but watch. They just pass right through each other, almost like they're ghosts. There's no big explosion, no immediate tidal disruption. They've clipped through each other. So what's happening? At the speed of light, the gravitational information from one galaxy doesn't have time to affect the other during the pass-through. The stars in one galaxy fly by the other before gravity can even begin to pull on them. But the interaction did happen, and the consequences are just delayed. And there it is. Now that they've passed each other, the gravitational shockwave from the encounter finally catches up to the rest of the galaxy. The structures are suddenly and violently torn apart from the inside out, creating this massive, empty gap between them where they used to be. But wait, where are the supermassive black holes that should be at the center? Let's search for them. There they are, flung completely out of the wreckage, traveling on their own into deep space. The encounter was so energetic, it acted like a cosmic slingshot, ejecting the densest objects, the black holes themselves. We are left with two shredded, chaotic remnants of what were once majestic spiral galaxies, destined to drift apart forever. What an unbelievable outcome. From graceful dances to total annihilation, we've seen just how powerful and strange the universe can be. Thank you so much for joining me on this journey through cosmic collisions. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next simulation.